Now you can see that the temperature rise so far has risen to 2.592. Within this 50 minute, it may rise to the higher value and then it may come down also. In that case, like in this case, you can see the temperature rise. It has risen to 2.601 to 2.604, 2.601, 604, 605, 601, 602, 602, and now it is down, 585. So it will use the maximum temperature rise for the calculation part. See, this beep is there. Now it has shown temperature rise is 2.608 and GCV value is 5808. And here all the calculation part is there. Like water equivalent is this, it was set earlier. Temperature rise is this. It has taken the highest value, 2.608. Then CVT plus CVW, 30.32, mass of sample, 1.050. And then GCV is this. Now for benzoic acid case, our main objective is to find out the water equivalent. So to find out the water equivalent, we have to press the fire button again. When I'll press the fire button again, at this point, see, it is asking the calorific value. Now it is asking the calorific value, what calorific value of benzoic acid that we have used. In every benzoic acid box, we paste the value of this. The benzoic acid calorific value is 6319. So we have to feed this value, not the value that just given by the machine. So we will feed 6319 when it is already there. So I'll move further, and again when I'll press menu button, it will show the water equivalent. This water equivalent is 2555, and you can see report is also there. Temperature rise, CVW, mass of sample, non-calorific value 6319, and water equivalent is 2555. So this way we have to find water equivalent for three samples and then take the average of that sample, and then we have to feed in the water equivalent. Now our this test is over. So first of all, we'll switch off the stirrer. We will switch off the stirrer, then we'll take out the sensor first. Then we will take out the stirrer unit. Keep it backside. Open the combined lid. Remove the lid. Take out bomb with bomb lifting hook. Now to open the bomb, we'll press this. It will not open. First we have to release the oxygen. One gas leasing pin is here in the accessory box. Only after release of oxygen, then only this bomb can open. Otherwise, it won't open. Now open. Take the lid up, and now see the crucible. Now you can see there is no sample left. Absolutely nothing. 100% complete combustion. So this is what it is desired. In case of coal samples or other sample, some unburned material
left. So we have to take notice of that thing also. We have to measure that thing also. So this is how this complete work experiment is done. Now one thing I will show that the last calorific value was 5808. So now if I go to the first, I will press the back button, menu button. Now I will go to the memory option, up memory option, then press menu button. So the last result is third in memory location. Third value is 5808. If I see memory, if I press the up button, it will show the memory location 4. So it is empty now. So whatever last result we do, if I do next result, then its value will come to the fourth value, like that. So this is all about model RSB7. In case of model RSB6, we do not have this printer. The unit in no sorry we have this printer, but the auto, instead of auto gas unit, we have this type of gas filling arrangement. We have this oxygen, then we have oxygen control valve, then we have the flexible tube. This flexible tube goes to the safety device, and then after safety device, it will go to the pressure gauge, and after this pressure gauge, this will go to the like this. We have to tie. So in case of our other models, oxygen filling system is like this: oxygen control valve, flexible tube, safety device, pressure gauge, and then two bomb. As we open this oxygen control valve now, this oxygen is start coming from this point to bomb through this safety device and pressure gauge. And when this pressure gauge shows 26 kg, then we will stop by rotating this knob. So this is in our other models. So this is all about working operation of digital bomb calorimeter. Thank you.